Hey Scrappers. Question: does Tevecom always means good? Let's check together. I found four big devices. This is an Intel 330T. You can see here. And I'll open these four devices. They're pretty big ones. They were used in Tevecom, big Tevecom racks. And let's check what's inside. Let's start with the first one. Okay, we have some screws, but let's look at it. Mainboard, nothing. I see one huge nothing. This is a port, this is a port, the cards are missing, okay. But here, one chip, couple of other small ones. Nothing interesting, nothing impressive so far. But let's continue. Because maybe ICs are hidden under this aluminum heatsink. So let's check together. Yes, there are some. And this is a good piece of aluminum. So what we have here? We have this how many there are? Six in total, but four big ones. Yes, these are good ones for gold recovery. But so far, nothing really astonishing or amazing or spectacular, or how to say. Yes, some gold plating here and here. On this board, I don't see anything interesting. No, nothing. So, number one, let's say, not bad, but nothing impressively good. Okay, we are ready with the first one. Nothing impressive. Couple of chips, couple of ICs, nothing impressive really. Let's look on the other side, nothing. On this side, nothing really impressive. Couple of capacitors, not even MLCCs, tantalum ones. So let's remove the first one and put the second one. Full scrap in here. Let's have a look at this British Tevecom BNC old standard old device. Here we go. All told but gold. Look at this optic fiber. So it's old, but it's not that bad. Let's quickly remove this small board and let's check what's under it, because it looks really interesting. Okay, some gold plated pins, a blue box, probably nothing inside. Let's quickly break it and have a look. Yeah, this is the place where the optic fiber changes into, so, BNC standard. It's like a, I think it's, this is the, I need a bigger screwdriver. And let's break it. So here we go. Here I see some gold, and that's nice. That's nice. There is some gold. There's some MLCCs. Small nice board. But actually, not that much and not that impressive. Besides the huge capacitors here and there. And unfortunately, all these capacitors, they are not MLCCs. I see tantalum and I see these old electrolyte ones. Nothing interesting here, nothing impressive. Just a board, pick and sell. So This is definitely not something to waste time to remove the elements and to stockpile anything for gold recovery. No, that's not the right one. Let me just quickly cut this big white messy. Okay, so a couple of more screws. I will remove the boards and show you what is on them. Guys, so from this one I got dead boards. This one here, nothing spectacular, some gold plating here and there. In the BNCs, in these ports, I can see some gold plating. Looks good, looks yellowish. This small card, I have some ports here and one huge IC. Probably good gold content in it, but nothing spectacular. Let's move to the next one. And here it is. This device, I'll tell you, this is Tricom. This should be a good one. I hope. I deserve at least one good one. Look at this beauty. Now this is a different story. Let's look together at it. Yes, that's a different story. I will remove all the boards now and show you what I mean by it's a different story. First of all, look at these ICs. They're huge. They're everywhere. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Probably some more hidden under the power supply. So these ICs, they definitely have a gold wiring inside. Also, look at the size of this BGA chip. It's a huge one. But let me quickly remove all this stuff and I'll show you the board. Okay, I'm back. Look at this. This is the first good one. We have 12 nice ICs, one BGA. We have some other ICs. We have good MLCCs, not many, but these are good quality ones. These ports have gold plating inside. We have this Razer card that was here in this port, and we have this nice card, slot card, good gold plating, second BGA, memory chips, IC, so really good one. Here only diodes, nothing interesting, but some gold plating. And of course, this cable is hiding some gold plated pins. This was not bad. But let's go to the fourth one. Let me get rid of this metal. I'm sure about one thing. At the end, I'll have a lot of metal. And number four is here. Optic device, optic fiber. Let's open it. And if you want to see a device in which you have nothing, not a huge but relatively big nothing, even in a small router you can have more than in this device, here it is. I'm wondering, is it a good idea to scrap it at all? Because in this device, besides the tantalum capacitors, this chip, probably a good one, have to remove the aluminum heatsink, this BGA, some memory chips, but that's literally nothing. I don't see, this is expensive device, but I really don't see anything to scrap here besides a couple of chips. I mean, I can show you internet modem, I can show you home network device with more value than this one. So does Tebecom always means good? I would say no. The best approach from my perspective is to buy, if you buy, always look at the boards. Because if you look at the boards, you can probably spend your money on this one that has 13, 14, 15 ICs and Razer cards, etc. So many sources and some palladium capacitors. Don't spend your money on devices. If you find them for free, that's good. But don't pay without opening the device and checking what's inside. Because you may end up with something like this. And this is half power supply and half board with one CPU, only one CPU here. So in general, nobody will pay you good money for this, even if you sell it as a board and there is no value to recover in terms of gold value. That's all from me. Thanks for watching.